Hey!
Hi!
Oh, look at you. You look so pretty. So what's going on with you?
Nothing much. I am coming back.
You are?
Yeah, of course.
Wow. That's a...
Yeah.
Wow, when?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow? From New York City to here? Tomorrow. Wow. That's great.
I know. I miss you so much. So I can't wait to see you.
Doing a lot of social distancing here, like masks, hand sanitizers. You know, I take it really, really seriously. So, but that's great.
Yeah, I do too. And I'm fine too. So
yeah.
I can't wait. I'm going to be all over you.
Yes. All right. All over me. Great.
Okay. I can't wait to
see you. I can't wait. I love you.
All right. Miss tomorrow. You. Love you. Bye.
Tomorrow. He's coming tomorrow.
I am so happy you're here. I can't believe you're here all the way from New York City.
Yeah, I'm finally here. I'm happy.
How was the flight?
It was fine.
Good. You feel healthy and safe? I mean, I know you quarantined for like 2 weeks, right?
Yeah.
You did that, right?
No, yeah. I was definitely really
safe. You know how I am. You know, I get, right? Well, I'm glad you're here. My parents are really excited to see you.
I'm excited to see them.
You comfortable? Oh, you need more air?
Yeah.
Ah, you feel that? Arctic wind.
No, I don't. Is this really necessary?
You're comfy though, right? That's hospital grade plastic. Well, here we are.
Hey, are you gonna let me out of here? Jason! Oh my God!
Thanks for letting me out of the Jeep.
Oh, you're welcome.
Jason's taking the social distancing thing like really far.
Real far.
Are you gonna come hang out with us?
I can see you.
Great.
Love you.
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Washa washa.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Woo!
Hey.
Hey.
I'm so excited to have dinner with you. It's unbelievable.
Me too.
What do we got?
Well, I made your favorite spaghetti with heirloom.
Yes.
And then
yes.
Just some sides.
This looks incredible.
Yeah, eat up.
And you, I gotta say, you look beautiful. Really.
Thank you. You look safe.
Safe? Oh, this! Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, I forget I have it on. It's so lightweight. I would love some of that corn. That looks so good. You can put it in the feeding tube.
The feeding tube?
Yeah, just shovel it down in all of it. Give it to me. Yeah. Oh, yep. Mm-hmm. Bring it to Papa. Oh, yeah. Okay. That one.
You need some more salt?
Mm-hmm. That's good. It's really good. Yeah. More. Keep going.
Spaghetti?
Spaghetti would be delicious. Oh, boy. Is that heirloom tomato? So good. Yeah. Oh, I got a little right here. Yeah. You know what? I am parched. Yeah, that's good. I'm full. I am getting full. And I'm full. Just a little water.
Okay,
yep.
You're thirsty.
I am really thirsty. Okay. Delicious. Thanks, baby.
Yeah. Wow.
That's good. Some more corn here. I'm so glad you're here. So glad that you finally made it back. Can't wait for dessert. Are you choking? Oh my god. I'm coming! I'm coming! Are you okay, Emmy? Do I call CPR? Do I dial something?
What?
Got it.
Hey. You kissed me and I'm okay.
I know.
I don't have the Rona. You don't have it.
No, I don't.
Wow. Let's go out to dinner. Celebrate. Whoa. We need a celebration.
Out to dinner? Babe, 0 to 100. You definitely need to change before we go.
It's Jason O's Variatine Show. Now made for person, woman, man, camera, TV. Tonight, Emily Reed with special guest Billy Gilman, Michael Paul, your host Jason, and an all-star band. Now putting the O in Corona, here's Jason O.
Hey everyone, how are you? Welcome to Jason O's Variatine Show. I'm Jason Ostrowski. We're really glad that you're taking time to be with us this evening. Got a lot of new viewers out there, I know, on YouTube tonight, and we're happy to have you. Hey, it's been about a month since I've seen you, and a lot of stuff has happened. Kanye West announced he was running for president. Then he said he wasn't. Now, I think Kim Kardashian had a hand in this. I think I know what might have happened, because I've had the same thing happen to me before. Just the other day.
Hey, Todd, what's up, man? Nothing. Pup crawl? Yes, I am in. I am there.
We have dinner plans tonight. No, you're not.
I can't go.
Disney World reopened while we were gone, and keeping in line with their new safety measures, guests were met with a whole new world of changes. Among them, less people in the park, which is a good thing, I think. No scheduled parades, and surprise character appearances. Now, among them is the all-new Masketeers. Because they have Mouseketeers. Just kind of a rebranding thing. Hey, but that wasn't the only change. Americans going to Epcot were shocked to find most of the World Showcase was closed to them due to new travel restrictions that Europe has placed on U.S. citizens. I guess nobody told them that Epcot now stands for Every Possible Country Outlawing Travel. Tina Turner released a new mix of her 1984 hit song, What's Love Got to Do With It? It's a terrific song. Yeah, she was also going to re-release We Don't Need Another Hero from Mad Max, but well, I guess she thought we were already living in Thunderdome. An original copy of Super Mario Brothers, the video game, sold for $114,000 at auction recently. Now, the new owner is recovering, not from sticker shock, but from hitting his head on all those bricks to get so many coins. My fellow nerds out there. Now, speaking of coins, here in the United States, we're having a bit of a coin shortage due to the coronavirus. Now, when Canadian adult dancers heard this, they said, oh, if only, because, you know, they've got loonies and toonies up there, probably lots of black and bloonies. Hey, masks are causing a lot of problems. The whole mask versus non-mask wearing controversy is crazy. I don't think we've had such a divisive clothing issue since The Thing wore a helmet. That's another one for my nerd friends out there. Hey, I was in the store the other day, and a woman bumped into me. She looked up and she said, I'm sorry, it's this mask I can't see with it on. Well, there's two takeaways from that. I don't think she knows how to properly wear a mask. Probably watch my PSA from last episode. And that woman is driving a car!
She's out there driving a car. It's crazy. And finally, the New England Patriots announced their plans for when they restart playing games this season. They're going to be playing to only 20% crowds. Now, that's not because of COVID-19. That's just because they don't have Tom Brady anymore. Bills fan. I'm happy they don't have Brady anymore. Hey, look, we've got a great show tonight. We've got Billy Gilman here to serenade you with his gorgeous voice. We've got comedy from Michael Paul. Emily is back. I'm happy about that. We've got members of the Grease Jazz Band, and they're going to be joined by some other friends of mine, Ryan Kindly, Trevor Jones, and Joel Miller. And also on a personal note, I would like to wish a happy belated birthday to two people. One, my mother. I love you, Mom. Happy birthday. And two, the guy that keeps this show sounding so great, a good friend of mine since high school, Mr. Rob Rhodes. Happy belated birthday to you, Rob. And since we probably won't be on again until the end of August, I want to wish a preemptive happy 70th, 7-0, birthday to my dad. Who'd have thought your 44-year-old son would be in the basement doing a show on Facebook? Anyway, stick around. We've got a terrific one tonight. I hope you have as much fun watching it as I had making it.
Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. When evening rolls around and it's time to go to town, where do you go? To rock and roll. The old folks say that you gotta end your day by 10. If you're out on a date and you're bringing home a leg, it's a sin. It's all because your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. The evening rolls around and it's time to go to town. Where do you go? To rock and roll.
Out of the car, long hair.
Ooh-wee. Come on with me. The local police.
And it's all because
your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. The evening rolls around and it's time to go to town. Where do you go? To rock and roll. Where do you go? To rock and roll. Where do you go? To rock and roll.
Goodbye, Norma Jean. Though I never knew you would only have the grace to hold yourself with those around you. Crawled out of the woodwork and then whispered into your brain that set you on a treadmill and made you change your name. It seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. I'd like to know you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before the legend ever did.
was tough, the toughest role you ever played. I'm a credit, a superstar, and pain was the price you paid. Oh, even when you died, oh, the press still hounded you. All the papers had to say was that Marilyn was found. Seems to me you've lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. Would have liked to know you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before the legend ever did. Goodbye, Norma Jean. Though I never knew you at all, you had the grace to hold yourself with those around you crawl. Goodbye, Norma Jean. From a young man in the 22nd row, sees you something more than sexual, more than just our Marilyn Monroe. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. Who'd like to know you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before the legend ever did. Oh, I would like to know you. Candle burned out long before the legend ever did. find her. I was moving in at the Parkway Diner. We never knew we could want more than that out of life. Shawty, Bender, and Eddie would always know how to survive. Said they were crazy. Plenty of knowledge, much too lazy. And Eddie could never afford to live that kind of life. Oh, but then we were waving Brenda and Eddie goodbye. Oh, oh, oh. Well, we got an apartment with deep pile coffins and a couple of paintings to see us. Big water bath and bar with a breath they saved for a couple of years. Started to fight when the money got tight. Just didn't count on the tears. Oh.
First guest tonight was a country star at just the age of 12. 12. The 12 I was down here probably playing with my Tonka trucks and He-Man. But not this guy. He's also a two-time Grammy Award nominee, a recipient of the Billboard Music Award. He's got a new single out called Soldier. He just did a concert last night at a drive-in movie theater, and yet he found time to be here with us. Oh, yeah, and by the way, he was runner-up on The Voice a few seasons ago on Team Adam. So there's that. Not bad. Please welcome my friend, Billy Gilman.
Be safe, be well, and thank you so much for allowing me to be here. This is There's a Hero.
Mm-hmm. There's a fire inside of everybody, burning clear and bright, and there's a power in the faintest heartbeat that cannot be denied. Go on and trust yourself, 'cause you can ride the wind. You're gonna take your dreams where they've never been. There's a hero in everybody's
Beautiful as always. Thank you, Billy, so much for joining us here tonight. Hey, give Billy a follow on Facebook and Instagram while you're at it. At Billy Gilman, official. Do it.
Now the south side of Chicago is the baddest part of town. If you go down there, well, you best beware of a man named Leroy Brown. Now Leroy, in more than trouble. You see, he's standing about 6'4". All the downtown ladies call him Treetop Lover. Men just call him Sir. And he's bad, 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 bad Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Junkyard dog. Now Leroy likes to gamble, likes his fancy clothes. He likes to wave his diamond ring in front of everybody's nose. He got a custom Continental. He got an Eldorado too. He got a 32 gun in his pocket for fun. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong. Meaner than a junkyard dog. Now Friday, about a week ago, old Leroy was shooting dice. And at the end of the bar sat a girl named Doris. Woo! That girl looked nice. So he cast his eyes upon her. And the trouble soon began. Old Leroy Brown, he learned a lesson by messing with the wife of a jealous man. And he's bad, 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 bad Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong. Meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, the two took to fighting.
And when they pulled him from the floor, old Leroy Brown looked like a jigsaw puzzle with a couple of the pieces gone. And he's bad, 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 bad Leroy Brown, baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong, meaner than a junkyard dog. And he's bad, 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 bad Leroy Brown, baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong, meaner than a junkyard dog. He was badder than old King Kong, meaner than a junkyard dog. And now it's time to grab a drink and sing along in the piano far.
Hey, everybody. Welcome. Come on in. Come on in. Welcome to my piano far. That's right. I said piano far. Because while I am sat at a piano, that is true, this is hardly a bar. Unless you go up to Dad's liquor cabinet. But that's beside the point. It's a piano far because you are far away from me. And that makes me sad. But through the magic of technology, quite a few of you are going to join me on this next song. You may be looking at this coat thinking, he's going to do something from The Greatest Showman, and you would be wrong. I'm going to put on my favorite glasses here. And we are going to sing one of my favorite songs.
Young, he and Susie had so much fun, holding hands, skimming stones. Had an old gold Chevy, place of my own, but the biggest kick we ever got was doing a thing called the Crocodile Rock. On the other people rocking round the clock, we were hopping and bopping, Crocodile Rock. Well, Crocodile Rocking is something shocking when your feet just can't keep still. Never will. Lord and Mama, it's Friday night. Susan wore her dresses tight and Crowder Rockin' was out of sight. Come on!
La 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 la.
But the years went by and Rock just died. Susie went and left us for some foreign guy. Long nights crying by the record machine, dreaming of a Chevy, of old jeans. But they never keep the thrills we got. Running up to the Crocodile Rock, running fast as the weeks went past. We really thought the Crocodile Rock would last. Well, Crocodile Rocking is something shocking when your feet just can't. Lord and Mama was Friday nights, and Susan wore her dresses tight and Crowder Rockin' was down of sight. Do it again, come on.
La, 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 la.
Come on. Was doing a thing called the Crocodile Rock. All the other kids were rocking round the clock. We were hopping and bopping, Crocodile Rock. Well, Crocodile Rocking is something shocking when your feet just can't be still. I never knew me a better time, I guess never will. Oh, Lord, Mama, those Friday nights, and Susan wore her dresses tight and Crocodile Rocking. One more time, nice.
everybody. I'm so happy you could join me here in the piano far. Now get out. Just kidding. We'll see you next time.
Hi there. These are unprecedented times, and thousands of people are out of work. It's hard for everybody. But we want you to know that here, at your labor department, we are working around the clock. That's my break. Like I was saying, we are working around the clock.
Cake in the break room.
Cake? Whose birthday is it? He's going left. He's behind that dumpster. Ah, no! He's... Come on, we've been at this for 4 hours.
We've lost the lead.
We're sorry. The number you have dialed is not in service at this time.
I'm not unemployed. You're unemployed. Shut up, Nancy. It's not your turn. I've had the time of my life. This is the best office party we've ever had, guys. Am I right? So keep at it. Log in online or call us. You'll get your benefits sooner or later.
I've known our next guest for more years than I can count. You've seen him on The Tonight Show. You've heard him on SNL. He's opened for Bette Midler in Vegas. Who is this guy? Oh, yeah. And he was on America's Got Talent. He's my friend. He's a funny guy. Please welcome Michael Paul.
Hey, Jason. Oh, it's Michael Paul. Thank you for inviting me to the Variety Show. This is so much fun. I am so sorry the puppets can't be here. They are in quarantine. But, you know, I just wanted to offer you something in front of an audience. Remember an audience? Oh my gosh, I remember like it was yesterday.
I'm going to start tonight today with a slightly quieter demeanor so I don't spook the animal. This is Willie. Willie has excellent vocal skills. I don't know if you know, anything about birds that have vocal skills. These skills are genetic. It does take, you know, peanuts or seeds or some kind of incentive to help move their vocabulary along. And I've been working with this animal for about a year and a half. I'd like to show you what we have learned. Willie, say hello. Say hello. Say hello.
Hello.
Very good there. Very good. I'd like you to welcome Willie, of course, by saying hello, Willie.
Hello, Willie.
Very good there. Nice job. Okay, great. Let's talk about the species. First of all, these birds are mimics.
These birds are mimics.
Which is impressive.
Which is impressive.
But confused for intelligence. Screw you. Okay, when you have a non-domesticated animal in a domestic setting, I will say the biggest problem is focus.
Now you look like her.
Her?
Yeah, you like that lady? Yes, I do.
Say hello.
I can't.
Just say hello.
Hello.
She said hello back. Now ask her name.
Huh. What's your name?
Her name is Judy. Now say something nice to Judy.
You want
to
get naked?
Hey, manners,
please.
Oh, come on.
She's a nice looking lady.
Yes, she is.
Are you interested?
What?
In Judy?
I am dating someone.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
Who are you dating?
I'm not discussing it in front of strangers because
you're not dating me.
I'm dating someone.
Gorgeous?
Yes.
That's your mistake.
What do you mean?
Those gorgeous ones leave you sooner or later.
The ugly ones leave you too.
Yeah, but who cares?
Judy! Woo! All right, look, you're out of control. Remember this? Now, folks, when animals are in a new environment, aside from focus, obedience is really important, not only for the safety of the audience, but the safety of the animal. What a lot of zookeepers and trainers and veterinarians use is a little hypnosis. And this isn't a heavy trance, but when I'm finished with Willie, when I say sing, he will sing. When I say sleep, he will sleep. When I say... Crap.
How's that throw, Deedians? Yeah. Okay, Judy, your turn.
All right, come on. Now, this animal seems very docile in captivity, but in the wild, he is known as a bird of prey.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam. I'm Jewish.
No, you're not. Look at my nose. Sorry, when you're dealing with an animal, it's a bit of a crapshoot.
Crapshoot. Come on!
When did I eat corn? What? I don't know. Now, most birds like this, I don't know if you know this, most birds, they swallow their food, and then their stomach churns the food into bile, and then they throw up the food to feed their young.
What the hell are you talking about?
You swallow the food to feed your young.
No, I don't. I do it to stay thin.
That's very Hollywood of you.
Yeah, me, Lindsay Lohan, the Olsen twins all hang out at Chuck E. Cheese.
Yes. Yeah, between that and that, I'm surprised you don't have bird flu.
I had it.
Did you?
Yeah.
Who gave it to you?
Sheryl Crow.
All right, you know, terrible. This would be a lot easier if you just do more bird things.
What do you mean?
What do you mean what I mean? Do you sing?
No.
Do you fly? Coach? So you just sit there and mimic everybody.
Hey, I am a master impressionist. That's what my species does.
You made your point. You do jokes, I do impressions. I got it. I could do a joke. I'm sure you could. Could you do an impression? Yeah, I could do an impression.
Go ahead, do it.
What?
Do it.
All right, I'll tell you what.
Huh?
I will do an impression,
yeah,
and then you tell me who I'm doing.
Okay.
All right, let me think.
Kim Kardashian.
You are tweeting without thinking.
Donald Trump.
Stop.
Diana Ross.
Shh. All right, I have one. Ready?
Yeah.
All right, who's this?
I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
Elton John.
No.
Ellen DeGeneres.
No. I'm going to do one more, and if you don't get it, we're done.
Fine.
It's like the most famous person of all.
Okay.
Ready? Who's this?
I'll be back.
Jesus Christ.
Number one, it's Arnold Schwarzenegger. And number two, come on. How about a round of applause for Willie, everybody?
Hey, Judy. Judy, I'll meet you after the show. Hey.
What can I say? Thank you, Michael. Thank you. I will try not to step in the bird droppings as I proceed with the show this evening. Hey, while you're at it, give Michael Paul a follow on Facebook and Instagram at Michael Paul Live.
In a slow hill, the girl every night at the hotel. I ain't seen the sunshine in 3 damn days. I've been fueling up on cocaine and whiskey. I won't wish I had a good girl to miss me. Lord, I wonder if I'll ever change my way. I put your picture away, sat down and cried today. I can't look at you, I'm lying next to her. I put your picture away, sat down and cried today. I can't look at you and I'm lying next to her.
I called you last night in the hotel. Everyone knows but they won't tell. But their half-hearted smiles tell me something just ain't right. I've been waiting on you for a long time. I put your picture away.
been. Since you've been gone, my world's been dark and gray. You reminded me of brighter days.
I hoped you were coming home to stay. I was headed to choose.
I was off to drink you away.
I thought about you for a long time.
Can't seem to get you off my mind. I can't understand why we're living life this way. I saw your picture today. I swear I'll change my ways. I just called to say I want you to come back home. Today, I swear I'll change my ways. I just called to say I want you to come back home. I just called to say I love you. Come back
home. About 11.
Well, that's it, everybody. That's the show. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you to everyone who was on the show. Billy Gilman, Michael Paul, Emily Reed, members of the Grease Jazz Band, Trevor Jones, Ryan Kindly, Joel Harrison Miller, my mom and dad, and all of you who sent in your Crocodile Rock videos. I appreciate it. Give me a follow on Facebook and Instagram, @TheJasonO, and we'll see you next time. Bye.